cause I'm bad for your health. I come real stealth, dropping bombs on your moms. Kill car alarms, doing foul crime. I'm that brother with the Alpine 7460. Always let tricks know and friends know we got that endo. No, I'm not a sucker sitting in a house of pain, and no, I'm not the butler.
What is your name and your age?
My name is Yessi Rivera and I am 45.
Efren Rivera, 47.
Where were you born?
I was born in Los Angeles, California.
I was born in Los Angeles, California.
What part of LA did you grow up in?
I grew up in South Central LA.
South Central Los Angeles.
Did you move around a lot?
When I was younger, yes. And then my mom purchased a home, so we had more permanent housing.
No.
How was school for you academically?
It was rough. English was not my first language, and we didn't have the same resources that our students now have, so yes, I struggled a lot.
Academically, it was a little challenging because my first language was Spanish, so I had to get into learn English.
What schools did you go to?
I went to first kindergarten was at 24th Street, and then we moved. So my second elementary became Vermont Elementary, and then Normandy Elementary. Then I went to middle school at John Muir. Then I got into some trouble there, so I went to John Adams. And then from John Adams, my mom thought it would be a great idea to ship me out to the Valley. So I went to El Camino High for about a semester, but it was difficult. Culture shock for sure. I'd never been around so many Caucasian people, so I felt inferior. And so I came back to LA and I did high school and manual arts, but unfortunately didn't graduate, so I got my GED.
For elementary, I went to Hooper Avenue School. For junior high, I went to Carver Junior High School, and for high school, I went to Jefferson High, but I graduated from Metropolitan Continuation School.
Did you have easy transportation?
No, absolutely not. We had to walk or get on the bus everywhere, for school or even for fun.
I walked to all my schools.
How long were those walks?
To my elementary, I walked about a mile. To my junior high, it was about a mile and a half. And for high school, it was about 2 miles.
How often were you in the city?
All the time.
It was mostly around my neighborhood.
What was the biggest challenge you had?
Staying out of trouble. I had a little tiny anger management issue. So, staying out of trouble and not hanging out with people that were bad influences.
Diversity.
Would you say being in LA brought on some of those challenges?
Absolutely.
What was your first job and where was it?
My husband and I had the same first job. So we both worked for Los Angeles Conservation Corps, but there's a subdivision that was called Cleaning Green. And we used to get paid to paint over graffiti and clean up empty lots.
My first job was Job Corps, and it was in LA.
Was there a hangout spot?
Not for me. My mom was super religious when I was growing up, so my hangout was my room.
So all my friends and I, we hung out in my apartment building.
What was the worst experience you had growing up?
One of my worst experiences that I went through was when I saw a couple of my friends that got killed in front of me.
I was 16, and there was an alley behind my my mom's house, and we heard gunshots. So my mom immediately, we called 911, and we had a cordless phone, and we she opened up the alley. She's like, go check to see if the person's okay. But when I got there, that person was taking their last breath, and the pool of blood was getting bigger behind his head. So when I was on the phone with 911, they were asking me, you know, did I think this person was gonna make it? And I had to tell them that no. Can we pause?
Music?
Yeah.
A drive-by shooting with a strange twist has left one man dead and three others wounded in South Central Los Angeles. At least 10 rounds were fired at the group from a stretch limousine. It happened just before midnight in the 200 block of West 47th Place. The man killed was 19 years old. Those wounded range in age from 15 to 28 years. Police say all the survivors are gang members.
What is your name and age?
My name is Marco Medrano, and I'm 47 years old.
My name is Jonathan Hathaway. I'm 36 years old.
Where were you born?
I was born in Los Angeles, California.
I was born in Bellflower, California, but I lived most of my life in Baldwin Park.
What part of LA did you grow up in?
I grew up in the county side. It was East Los Angeles. I lived on the borderline between the city of LA and the county of LA.
It's a little outside of LA, probably like 20 minutes, and it's a small city called Baldwin Park.
Did you move around a lot?
No, I lived in the same place.
No, not really. Stayed in that city most of my life.
How was school for you academically?
Academically for me, wasn't too bad. I passed my classes.
School's all right. It was kind of rough back then a little bit. There was a lot of gangs and stuff in school, a lot of different personalities. But, you know, I got through it, and, yeah.
What about socially?
Socially, my friends were my friends from the neighborhood, so.
What schools did you go to?
The elementary school was called Rowan Avenue Elementary School. I went to a junior high school called Robert Louis Stevenson Junior High School. And then for high school, I went to a high school called Francisco Bravo Medical Magnet High School.
All the schools were all in Baldwin Park, and I went to elementary. I went to Central Elementary, and then I went to Jones Junior High, and then I ended up at Sierra Vista High School.
Did you have easy transportation?
Yeah, I think so, because elementary school, junior high school, it was walking distance. And then for high school, I took the school bus, so that wasn't too bad.
Yeah, it was easy to get to school because everything was so close to each other. It was all like walking distance. The high school was like almost connected to the apartments I lived in, so I could literally just jump the gate and go into school.
How often were you in the big city?
Not very often. We went there, you know, maybe go see a movie or go eat at a restaurant downtown, but that was it. Maybe once a month or...
City, pretty often, almost like every weekend. Something was either going on or, like, you know, just kids getting into trouble a little bit, you know. I knew a lot of people who were into tagging, and everybody's always looking for a bridge, so.
What was the first job you had?
First job I had, I worked at Parks and Recreation in Los Angeles County.
The first job I had, it was in Baldwin Park. And I actually got it through ROP because I wanted to start working right away. And so I got it through ROP, and I ended up working retail sales, and then I ended up at Party City.
Was there a hangout spot?
Hangout spots like...
Like with your friends. It, like, it was just like you guys always went there.
It was always at somebody's house. Yeah, we always, you know, it was the neighborhood, so we all lived very close by. And so we would just go from house to house.
In Baldwin Park, yeah, we saw this place. It was like an old parking lot that it would, like, grow, like, super tall weeds, and it was just all dirt. We used to call it the Sandlot. And we used to just go hang out there all the time.
What was the best experience you had growing up?
The best experience growing up is just growing up, man.
I think it was cool, like, the area that I grew up, like, and experience-wise, like, I think just, like, because we're so close to everything, like, we're not too far from the mountains, too far from the beach, too far from the desert, anything, like, it was cool that, like, you could always go experience things, like, in a day because, you know, everything was so close to each other.
What was your worst experience?
Worst experience? I think the worst experience for me is gun violence, I think. You know, there's always shooting, or you hear the shooting, or you're at the spot where they're shooting, you know, but I think that's probably the worst experience.
The worst experience is probably all the gangs, like, because even though I didn't look the part, a lot of people would still, like, run up on you or hit you up and, like, just try to give you a lot of shit for nothing, or, you know, try to rob you, or just stupid stuff that just would just ruin your day sometimes. That was definitely, yeah, not a fun experience.
Would you consider it rough growing up?
I don't. Yes and no.
Yeah, I think maybe in that area it was a little rough, just because something was always going down, like fights and just craziness all around.